I'm not Irish, I'm Scottish, and so was John Jameson, who set up Jameson's Irish Whiskey. Working in Scotch, I've spent a lot of time with Irish brand owners from events around the world. Late night chats, and it's too long Irish whiskey has been in the shadow of Scotch, but times are changing. There are things you need to know, so let's dive in there just now. Hello, Hendo here. Welcome to What You Should Know About Irish Whiskey 2021. In this video, we'll explore the rise and restoration of Irish whiskey. The past few years has seen seismic growth and diversification in the category. A recent Irish Distillers Association report predicts sales of Irish whiskey in the US could overtake Scotch there in the next 10 years. That's no surprise to me because I've spent so much time in the US and seeing their presence in liquor stores and bars. Headroom has always been there, more Irish Americans than Scots Americans. St. Paddy's Day sales, remember, tequila sales double for Cinco de Mayo in May. And then there's Irish bars in every town. It's embedded in US culture. But Irish whiskey is growing up. There's a lot of ground to cover in this video. So without further ado, here we go. Let's talk about history, the grain and liquid, identity crisis, the players, politics, and the winds of change. First up, history and politics. The oldest and first document of whiskey production in Ireland was written in an Act of Parliament in 1556. In 1779, there were 1,228 registered distilleries in Ireland. After an Act of Parliament by 1790, there were 246, and by 1821, there were just 32 licensed distilleries. In 2010, four distilleries, Irish Distillers Limited, had a monopoly for three decades, but now it's up to 38. Most in the last 5 years. It's a story of 19th century growth, then sharp decline in the 20th century, civil war, US prohibition, and trade dispute with the UK. Irish Whiskey Association, IWA, follows the Irish Whiskey Act 1980 and Irish Whiskey GI, Geographic Indication, under EU regulation. Governance is not as robust as the SWA, Scotch Whiskey Association in Scotland. Some want an SWA-style governance. Transparency and clearly naming the distillery on the bottle of Irish single malt whisky is being called for. Irish whisky has experienced a phenomenal decade in 2010-2020. Craft distilling, gin craze, craft beer, poaching, and now Brexit, tariffs, COVID-19, lockdown causing on-trade slump. Irish whiskey has taken a few knocks, but it's on the right track to finally reclaiming its heritage. Ireland used to have three distilleries on the island and only one of them that was producing a liquid for sale. So brand marketeers had to get creative. Depending on where you live in the world, what Irish whiskey brands you'd see. Owning a distillery is not a prerequisite to buying or having an Irish whiskey brand. And this leads us to identity crisis and Paddy Whackery. Would-be distilleries need cash flow to create a brand using stock already on the market from a bulk supplier, bound to non-disclosure agreements by their whisky suppliers. Some might call it ugly growth, like winning ugly in a football match. We are where we are at the moment. With the right strategy, though, can you switch to being sustainable in the future once resources are built? Identity crisis, label confusion, brands with liquid that have no relationship with location on the bottle and the label. Confusing statements. There are many examples out there of the brands in the market. Speculator brands trying to appear artisan when they're not. It's hoped transparency and provenance will outgrow this. It takes time. A 10-year Irish Distillers report came out in December 2020, and it looks like Irish Whiskey Association is finally heading to make amendment proposals, a call now that's been revised to the technical file to actually reflect the history. The grain and liquid, Irish grain whiskey, often maize with a small percentage of malted barley in the mash, blends, triple distilled, column distilled. Irish pot still, geographical indication for Irish pot still whiskey, minimum 30% unmalted barley. And malted barley is used in the mash and distilled in copper pot stills. Irish single malts, 100% malted barley at a single distillery, usually triples distilled in copper pot stills, but things are changing. The image of mellow triple distilled is being challenged. Cheaper blended whiskey is a volume market in the US, but in share, is it starting to decline? Higher value premium products are on the rise. Even the big guys get their grain from the continent, but the end product is distilled and matured in Ireland. Irish whiskey is made with a blend of malted and unmalted barley in the pot still phase. Mature stocks are now coming of age, till they're mature, etc. There are real artisans aging spirit in warehouses across Ireland just now. Watch the mid-2020s for prime quality that was laid down 5 or 6 years ago. The Irish whiskey industry is moving into a golden era. By Irish law, Irish whiskey must be aged for a minimum of 3 years in barrel. Not like Scotch whiskey, which is in oak casks. Teeling, for instance, has over 100 different cask styles. So, on to the players. I've met most brands on the road, some brand owners who are clearly building to exit with little interest in the category itself. There is the good, the bad, and the downright ugly, but I'm not here to judge, and these are going to likely change over time. Major foreign investment has really propelled Irish whiskey. Irish Distillers Limited were instrumental in infrastructure growth. Let me whiz through some of the brands. Jameson's, of course, super famous. Middleton Distillery, currently the largest operating pot stills in the world, and Ireland's largest distillery, produces many well-known whisky brands. Jameson, Middleton, Paddy, Powers, Redbreast, Writer's Tears, The Irishman, Green Spot, Yellow Spot, Blue Spot. Irish Distillers was formed in 1966 when John Power and Son, John Jameson and Son, and the Cork Distillery Company merged. In 1972, Bushmills joined the group and Irish Distillers became the sole producer of whisky in Ireland for more than a decade. Now a subsidiary of French drinks group Pernod Ricard since 1988, Irish Distillers remains the largest distiller of Irish whisky to this day. Then Jose Cavero bought Bushmills from Diageo in 2014 and doubling capacity. Conor McGregor's hugely successful Proper 12 launched in 2018 and just sold to the owner of Jose Cabrera. Beam Suntory 2012 bought Cooley's, the original third-party supplier from the Teeling family. Brands like Kilbeggan Whiskey, Connemara, Tyrconnell, Lox, Green Ore. Teeling set up in Dublin 2012 and Bacardi acquired a stake in Teeling Whiskey 2017. William Grant & Sons bought Tullamore Dew 2010, further investment 2017, and is needing older, mature stocks. Brown-Forman bought Slane Castle 2015 and has built a new distillery. Walsh Whiskey, roots back to 1999, has the Irishman and Writer's Tears brands. Quintessential Brands bought the Dubliner in 2016. Dublin Liberties Distillery is in production, 2 years old now. Glendalough 2011 sold to Mark Antony Brands 2019. West Cork Distillers 1999 produces Hyde Whiskey, the one with the labelling issue. Clanachilty Distillery, Lambay is Dublin based with the Baring family and French Camus Cognac. The Sexton by Proximal Spirits. Sleeve League in Donegal backed by the Japanese drinks giant that owns Nika. Dingle Distillery 2012, Porterhouse Brewing Company, Craft Producer of the Year 2020. Killarney Distillery, another brewer distilling rising trend. Waterford Distillery, Mark Renier, Terroir Driven Spirit, Connac Distillery, Tipperary Boutique Distillery, Kinahan Irish Whiskey, Bond Distillery in 2015 by the Cooney family in Drogheda, bringing back lost recipes and have the Whistler brand. Roe & Co, Independent Bottlers, W.D. O'Connell, J.J. Corey Irish Whiskey, Bonding. Heaven Hill owns Irish Mist. Great Northern Distillery in Dundalk is now the go-to source for start-up whiskey firms, set up by John Teeling 2015. This is not exhaustive. If I've missed you out, let me know in the comments. The landscape is ever-changing. Expect brands like Campari and others to re-enter this vibrant category. Now the winds of change. COVID, Brexit, tariffs. Irish cream liqueurs switching to wine base to skip the US whiskey tariffs. And recent changes in Japan this month, new standards has implications for bulk Irish whiskey export suppliers. Brexit, teething problems, paperwork and delays are ongoing. COVID killed the on-trade, which was a feeder channel for new brands of craft size for their growth. Duty-free global travel retail also hit Irish brands hard. Sales slumped 64%. US 42% of Irish whiskey exports. Some say it's too reliant on the US, but there's interesting growth in Africa. I saw back in 2013 the Love for Irish Whiskey, Whiskey Alive Festival in South Africa. The next couple of years are going to be really crucial for Irish whiskey. Will some of the exciting brands make it? In the shakeout, financial resilience and robust business models are being tested. Let's hope the artisanal survive. Instead of an Irish whiskey renaissance, you could call it a restoration. They were the leaders and found themselves out in the wilderness. Not now. Things are looking much healthier. Frustrations from insiders want to see better governance and leadership from the Irish Whiskey Association. Better balance. But I think that will come. Expect to see brands move away from the St. Paddy wackery and campaign on authenticity. A good thing, I feel. I've seen the carnage in Chicago and other cities. It really feels like there's a drive to reconnect broken links to the past, restore provenance. So it's time to start updating your Irish whiskey palate. Get rid of the old cliches, smooth, triple distilled, etc. And start embracing a new era of whiskey profiles. There's a desire to make better terroir, use natural peat, single malts and mature artisanal stock with rich, deep and complex flavours. We're still in spring 2021, so expect plenty more changes. So tell us what you think of the Irish whiskey scene just now. I'll add more videos on a series. And if you're interested in whiskey projects, contact us at hendotalks.com. As always, welcome your comments and feedbacks. If I missed you out, let us know. I hope this was useful to you in some way. And until next time, thanks very much for watching.